doing this new thing where she's vlogging everything.
Made this here with all the ice on in the booth. At the gate outside, when they pull up, they get me loose. Yeah, jump out, boys, that's Nike boys hopping our coupes. Way too big, when we pull up, give me the loot.
Give me the loot!
Was off the Remy, had up at post.
So, first I'm going to talk about, like, probably my favorite quality style hair extensions so far. And that's going to be cashmere hair extensions. So these, I think, were based off of Shark Tank. That's where they got started out or whatever. And I really like these because, like, they're just really, like, real hair. I mean, like, I know that everything that you buy that says 100%, it has to be 100%, right? I mean, they wouldn't, like, lie to us, would they? But this hair itself, like, if you get it wet, it's gonna, like, dry, like, curly, like, a naturally wavy, like, and thick. It's very full and thick, and I love their hair extensions. The only thing is they don't offer a halo, and I prefer a halo because I feel like the clips, like, tug and pull on your hair. They can create, like, bald spots after time, and that's what I, like, don't really like to mess with that much. So I do would say that, you know, you should use, like, a halo, but I do recommend the cashmere hair extensions. So the second one that I want to be talking about today is the Halo by Glam Seamless, and this was my baby for a very, very long time. She got dyed, cut, all that, and I wore her every single day. She was literally, like, my go-to. I love her so much, but unfortunately she is kind of coming to an end here, as you can see. Starting to get, like, a little frizz at the bottom. It probably could still be revived with, like, some product and stuff, but I have dyed her darker, bleached her lighter, and, you know. So now I'm gonna go ahead and move on to the ZALA hair extension halo. I got the 20-inch. I believe it was only $179. And compared to the Glam Seamless, that is super affordable because I'm pretty sure it was $100 more for the Glam Seamless. The Glam Seamless is thick enough to wear on its own. And I would say the same about this one. I just haven't gotten it trimmed yet. But here it is. It is very full. It's very nice quality hair. It's very long. I've actually already curled it because I always wear mine curly, but as you can see, if your hair doesn't have any layers in it and you curl it, it's only gonna curl here at the bottom. But if you put layers, like, all through here, your curls can be all throughout, and it'll be easier to blend with your hair, and it will look more like it's your hair and it's not hair extensions. So what I'm gonna do is show you what these look like in my hair without anything else. And then I'm going to show you what I do. See, if you have thicker hair, you may need to go ahead and part it first and then put here. But my hair is, like, so thin and it's short that I can literally just brush it on top. This doesn't work for everyone. It might be better if you have, like, something sharp that you can kind of, like, go in here with it. You don't want to, like, pull or tug on your hair if it gets stuck on the clip, so make sure you, like, remove it from the clip and then pull through so that it's not tugging on your hair. So that is just, like, 3-second hair, which is why I prefer halos over any other style hair extension, because it's not tugging on my actual hair. It's literally sitting on top with a wire, and it's instant hair. Literally, it's so beautiful. For me, I like to stack two halos, and sometimes I will do one halo and then some clips maybe in the front for the bangs, or, you know, some layers in the back. I'm gonna show you what it looks like. I haven't curled my real hair yet, so you'll be able to see the difference. So what I have here again is another halo. This was a cheaper halo. I got this from Amazon. It's human hair. It's called LaVoo, L-A-A-V-O-O. Not really sure about the distributor. There's not many videos on YouTube about it. I was literally just taking a shot in the dark with this. I just needed something at the time because everything that I had was not the color of my hair. So I bought this one, and the problem with it is it's not the same color as my hair now. But I do need something to stack this with so that I can be super like thick and voluminous. So I'm just gonna put this underneath so it will kind of blend. I might see about getting my hair dyed or toned down a little so that it will match better, but I'm not really sure how much my hair can like withstand right now, so I'm not gonna actually try until I go talk to the salon. So I'm gonna put this one underneath and then show you guys what it looks like. So this is before I get them trimmed and layered. And this is the LaVoo stacked up with the ZALA halo. One more thing I wanna add about the ZALA hair extensions that I love is that they're already blunt cut like this. So don't mind this, because this is the other one, the LaVoo. But this is the ZALA, the more high quality one. So I love how it's already blunt cut. So when I go to the salon, I'm gonna make sure that they keep that because it just looks so like healthy. So I went to the salon to get the hair layered and textured by a professional. I went to E.A. Wells Hair and Design, and this is Melissa. She was so kind to help blend the hair extensions with my hair, and also she allowed me to film so I could add this footage to the video. So I'm very thankful for her, and I do recommend if you're wearing hair extensions that you go to a professional salon and have somebody who knows what they're doing blend the hair extensions with your hair so that it will look real and natural and people won't be able to tell that you're wearing hair extensions. So as you can see, the hair is already looking fuller and nicer since going to the salon. So this is just a little bit of footage of me styling my hair extensions and how I make them really blend and look nice with my hair. So if you're wearing longer hair extensions, you may not want your hair to be super curly at the top because you'll be able to see where your real hair stops and where your hair extension starts. So it's better to have very subtle curls at the front and at the top, and then let the curls at the bottom be a little bit more dramatic so that it's not so much of a drastic change between the two.